Catherine from Book Creator. This tutorial is to is for specifically students and parents. Your teacher should have shared a specific invite code or have given your student a QR code to have them join a library. They do have access to log into Book Creator, and the teacher is the owner of the materials inside the site of Book Creator. So they do not need a specific login. They just need to make sure they have that specific invite code or the QR code. Okay, what you're going to do is you're going to go to Book Creator. .com. When you get to bookcreator.com, you're going to click on sign in. And if you are on an iPad, make sure that you do go onto the Safari or on a tablet. You can also use any browser. Just click on the browser and go there. You do not need to use the app. Okay? When you're here, you're going to go to the student sign on. Make sure you do not sign in as a teacher because it will knock you off and have you sign in as a student. So sign in as a student. You have options here. If your school has Clever, they can sign in with Clever. They can also use their Google login, the Microsoft login if you're a Microsoft school, or a QR code too. So for me, I'm going to sign in with Google. I'm going to pretend that I am a student to show you what you see. Okay, scroll down. This is my student, one that I use as a practice one. Cool. And now what it's going to ask you to do is you can go to my library. It's going to have you join your teacher library. Normally that pops right up on the screen. So here I'm going to join my teacher library, and I need to type in that library code. So here is my teacher library. I'm going to type in join the library. Now your student could have access to multiple libraries from multiple teachers. So there might be a different list of those from each teacher. Then when the student goes, if you click on up here, these three lines, I can view all of my libraries on the side. So I'm in, say I'm in Miss Capiello, which is me, but I'm the period two ELA class. I'm gonna click on period two. Now I have access to that library. If a teacher, let's say, creates a template for you to copy, you'll notice here they might put a template, they might have copy this and so forth, different ways that you can do that here. Maybe they did create a template and now you need to copy that and you're going to create your book from there. Down here, you're going to go on and press this little book icon and you're going to click copy book. I'm going to put it right into the same library because it's period two. And now I have a copy of my book. Or the book, the template the teacher gave me. I'm going to delete this, and now I'm going to name it my own. I'm going to, maybe it's Johnny's Journal. And then I can also click on the name down here. My computer's freezing. Anyways, you can edit. You can edit the name as well. It's not working in a second right on my computer because it's going slow. But you can edit and change that and so forth, and now you have your template. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the edit button. And now I can go in and edit this book just as if it was my own. So I can click on date, double click, put in today's date, happy St. Patrick's Day, and so forth. They can add their name, this journal belongs to, I'm going to click in the shape, Johnny. Everything right there. You can add stuff, pages, so forth. If I click on pages, what I can do here, maybe my teacher wants me to create a journal entry for every single day. What I would do here is I just go click on these three dots on the bottom of the page, and then I can just copy. You can also move these around too for your needs. Super easy to copy a book. So just look at your teacher's instructions to see if they want you to make that copy and go from there. Also, when you're in here, just think of this as a bookshelf in that teacher's library, and these are all the books. So you're going to see your classmates' books in here as well. when you're looking at your classmates' books, you can click on their book to read it. You can see, excuse me. I can read what they're doing. Another book. What I also can do on this bookshelf is I can look for any book that has these features right here. These features with these icons, that means that I can collaborate on this book. So what I can do here, do you see where it's an edit sign? That means I can edit that book. You'll notice I'm able to edit the book I copied, but I can't actually edit the original template that the teacher made. This one I can edit because it's on collaboration mode. So now I can go in here and now I can make edits, or maybe I want to add things to my classroom book. That's what those little icons mean. Now, maybe you want to create a new book on your own. This is what you'll do. You'll click on plus new book. I would always focus on creating or clicking on one of these comics at the bottom. It just means you have extra features. Does not mean that you're only creating a comic book. And now the only two things that you need to worry about here are the plus button and the inspector button. The plus button means that you're just adding something to the pages. So I'm either adding media, meaning pictures, videos, text, auto draw, I'm recording something. And the inspector is what you would click to change whatever you have made. So I want to change this cover, I'd go to inspector, and now I can change the color. I can also browse down here and change these different things too. Super cool. If I want to play my book to see what it would look like, I press the play button. Three dots, dot, 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 dot. Sorry, my internet is going slow. But you get the point. You'll click the play button and then it will play. Let's try one more time if it works. There we go. And now I can read my book. Like I said, super simple, two buttons, plus inspector, the main ones, play for the play, and then I can always rearrange using pages. I can move these around, I can copy, delete, so forth. Then I will have all my books, I will see my friend's books as well on that shelf, and I should be good to go. Now, let's say your teacher, another teacher says, hey, I want you to do this project, join my library. You'll just click on those three lines, go to join a library, and now type in the next code. Hopefully that helps.